What do we want? And we've learned that it's the community's choice. You know, I personally, I may not want a social club, but I have a wish for cultivation. We're putting these questions on the ballot in May just to see where the community is and what they do. At the end of the day, it's ultimately up to you.
And if I can validate these for a minute, because you definitely need to be validated, is, okay, beauty, you want people that have roots here to have the cultivation facilities open up the establishments. We're walking a fine line with discrimination there, for one. For two, we have established caregivers in the community that are already growing. So, again, one of the control measures that we can do here in town is we can limit the number of licenses that we dole out. So if we only dole out four cultivation, and this, I'm not, you know, for or against or anything, but this is just an idea, is if we only dole out four cultivation licenses for the town of Maine, guess what? All your caregivers just have all of your cultivation licenses because your caregivers are getting first crack at the licenses. And that's statewide. So that's something that we can do to alleviate that concern for the townspeople, is only dole out four cultivation licenses, and all four of the caregivers already have first crack at them. We have, you know, we just gotta be creative, honestly. We gotta listen to each other, we gotta have open, honest, calm conversations with each other, where we go back and forth and we have a meeting of the minds, because we can do this together, you guys. There's a lot of concern from a lot of different citizens. And no, I don't think that this is gonna get totally out of hand, I don't. And I don't wanna blow the whistle, I don't wanna be, you know, sending the signals or whatever.
The sky's not actually falling.
The sky's not falling. But at the same time, is I don't want 20 cultivation facilities popping up all around town. I don't want a huge cultivation facility on Five Corners. I don't want two or three or four or five of them popping up on the school road.
Yeah, but you have a property.
And that's
your rights tend to be a property around you.
No,
so
I get that.
And their rights open up and grow whatever, do whatever. As long as it's not polluting my groundwater or polluting my air.
No,
mind your business in this. And I want to put something else to it. It's basically economics. The more you regulate, the more dangerous marijuana becomes because of the black market aspect.
Yeah,
so you really don't want to be over stringent and stuff, because you're just going to make matters worse, because that creates the criminal element.
No, I agree. And I don't think that it's prerogative of the planning board to regulate this until there's so many regulations that nobody can open up here in town because it disincentivizes them. I don't think that that's planning board's prerogative. I'm speaking for myself, of course, but that has never, ever come up in conversation. Essentially, what we're trying to do is we're trying to put the footwork into it. We're trying to get all of the information out to you guys so that you guys can take it and you can run with it. And like I said before, we're going to have community workshops where we all come together. You know, it's probably not going to be this style of seating. You know, I don't like standing and I don't like, you know, I'm on a table right now. You know what I mean? It's probably not going to be like this setting. We might arrange the chairs so that we can all have open, honest conversations. But we basically want to facilitate you guys coming up with the control measures that you feel comfortable for here in town. You know, and that's our entire prerogative for this, is we want to do what's best for the town. We don't want it to get out of control. We want just enough in place in order to control it in the way that people see fit. That's essentially, you know, where we're coming from. Does anybody have any questions?
When you were up at the workshop, what was the kind of the feeling around the state of Maine? Are a lot of towns getting into controlling this, or we don't control it, but we become a map for people that are looking for a free open place to do it? Or what is it looking like out there?
Okay, that's a good two-part question. From some other communities that we reached out and chatted with that day at the workshop, a lot of them are kind of in the same boat. They're trying to figure out where this is going, what it's going to do for their communities. I believe it was
Brownville.
Brown, a small community up by Conway that there is about 1,400 people in town. But they're worried because they're a border town as well. They don't know what it's going to mean for their community. And they have nothing in place right now. They also don't have a police force to deal with any activity that may come around with that.
Or a comprehensive plan.
Put things in zone in certain parts of the community as opposed to just letting them pop up everywhere.
I would like to, just about every community is looking to control this in one way or another. There are some communities that are waiting until the state comes down. So for example, Lewiston has an all-out prohibition on any activity regarding retail marijuana until the state rolls out all their rules. They've already put that into place. There's a lot of communities in Maine that have rolled out moratoriums. There's a lot of other communities that are doing the wait-and-see approach. And that's the beauty of Maine, is that it's our town. You know, every town feels that way. It's our town. We're doing what's best for our town. So you're kind of seeing a lot of the different dynamics. To touch on your MECA comment, yeah, there's a potential of that. And the reason why I say that is because we already have some people from Massachusetts coming up and looking to build here. There's some other people from New Hampshire that are looking to build here. And the kind of the feeling, I think, was an incentive to build here is, for one, we're a border town. So we would get a lot of the tourist attractions coming from New Hampshire, because it's illegal there. And you can just drive, you know, 5 miles down the road and it's legal in Maine. So there's the border town aspect. And the other aspect is, I think, because of the control measures, we don't have a comprehensive plan, we don't have anything in place. I think that was another incentive. And the third, I believe, is because, and this is specifically for Massachusetts, is because their licensing fees are astronomical. Their licensing fees are tens of thousands of dollars, in some cases hundreds of thousands of dollars for a licensing fee, as opposed to a couple of thousand dollars here in Maine. Now, to touch on the licensing, is the local municipalities get 50% of the licensing fees from the state. So for example, if a cultivation facility, if the licensing fee is $2,000, 50% of that $2,000 is going to come back to Lebanon. That's $1,000 that's going to come back to Lebanon. That $1,000 we'll get every year, because it's an annual licensing renewal. So, but we're not getting any of the taxes. All of the taxes for retail marijuana are going to go strictly to the state. But that's another thing that we need to consider too, is the fact that, and that might change, but that's another thing that we need to consider too, is the monetary aspect of this. We can make some money off of it, we can.
No, I'm scared that people, like you said, Massachusetts companies, out-of-state companies are going to come here. It's a southern border town. We're connected right to the turnpikes and 202 major highways. It's right there. And the property prices right now, especially if it doesn't have a house on it, very low property prices right now.
That's
so a big corporation can come in here, suck up a bunch of land, chop all the trees down, and make a big industrial-looking thing. Now get 10 companies from Massachusetts, 2 from New Hampshire, another one from a couple states away to come in and do this to our properties in Lebanon, and what Lebanon looks like can change drastically in almost the blink of an eye.
And
so for anybody who's anti, you know, it's important that we make rules. And, you know, I don't want too strict rules, because, I mean, I'm all about marijuana and medicine and all that, but we've got to do something or we're going to regret it.
And that's all the much more reason to have local controls in place. That's all the much more reason to put it back into your guys' hands to have these, you know, conversations. That's all the much more reason why we need to get all this information out, and we need to have meeting minds, and we need to get together on this. That's all the much more reason. Because if we don't do anything, then that could happen, you know? But we have a lot of power. Municipality, we do. Go ahead.
I'm sorry, I caught hands here first. So.